Audio player Work Audiobook Lesson 4 Working with Notes Text for audio files. The goal of the Work Audiobook player is to learn you to understand foreign speech listening skill. To achieve this, we listen to audio files by phrases and listen these phrases again and again until we fully understand what we have heard. But what should you do if you listen to the phrase several times but still do not understand some words? Obviously, the audiobooks that you have downloaded somewhere must have corresponding text files. If you do not have the text, the quality of your learning will be poor. Be sure to have the text files for your audiobooks. Suppose you have found the right learning materials and you have the text. Then, if you don't understand something, switch to the text. And look for unclear fragment. In principle, it's possible to work this way. But you can make it even better. Copy the text to the Work Audiobook program. For this, the app has the notes functionality. Let's see where it is. Let's return to the Work Audiobook program. Pay attention to the Show button. It opens additional features of the program. So we have Notes for folder and Notes for file. Let's open both. You see, the new tabs have opened at the bottom of the window. The main part is a text input field. We can write something. There are toolbar at the top. Autosave turned on. Save. Let's click. Edit turns on and off the editing. Font size affects the alt text. Add words for study button. I will explain it in the next video. And at the right there is a name of the file where our notes will be saved. This file will be in the same folder with your MP3 file. For notes for folder, this file name will be notes.txt. For notes for file, this file name will be the name of your audio file plus in the end instead of MP3, there will be notes.txt. Here, Sherlock Holmes 01.mp3, this is our audio file. Here, Sherlock Holmes 01.notes.txt, this is our file with notes. Okay, let's copy the text for our audio into the notes for file. Delete what we have written. Switch to the program with the text. For example, this is some web page in Chrome browser. Select. You can press Ctrl A if you need to select all. Or select as much as you need with the mouse. Then right-click to open the context menu. Select Copy or Ctrl C. OK. Switch to Work Audiobook. Here also right-click in the text field. Choose Paste. Press Ctrl Home to go to the beginning of the text. Now all the text for audio is available in the program. We can make it bigger, for example 18. Let's play the current phrase. If you are used to use the keyboard, and I recommend doing just that, then press the spacebar. Yeah, we see. The spacebar just adds a space into the text. Not a problem, just switch the edit button off. Let's try again. Press space.
The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes.
Great, everything worked well. But sometimes we need both to write and to listen together. Let's say we write the notes and so edit is on. Then we should press Alt plus space.
The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes.
Okay, let's switch the edit off. However, some keys, even when editing is disabled, should be pressed together with Alt. For example, the left and right arrows on the keyboard are used to select a phrase. When we are in the notes window, they simply move the cursor in the text. But if we hold Alt, we see the arrows select the phrase. Okay, so we have two kinds of notes. As I said, I recommend to use notes for a file, for text for audio, and you can use notes for folder for something else. For example, when I listened to the audiobook's Game of Thrones, I kept a list of characters in the notes for folder, so I wouldn't be lost. For example. I'll give you some more tips. Despite the fact that we copied the text for audio, I would strongly recommend not to peep into it without necessity. So let's move the text lower. Listen to our phrase.
The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes.
And try to understand what we have heard. If necessary, press again.
The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes.
And only if you don't understand, then go down to peep into the text. This way you force yourself to listen, not to read. It's very important. Another tip. We can improve our text in the notes a little bit. The text that I have copied looked jumbled, without enough spaces between phrases. Let's improve it in some text editor. I will use my Microsoft Word. Sorry, I will use an old version with Russian UI, but I am sure you will be able to find the same commands in your modern version of Microsoft Word or some other text editor. Turn on the edit mode. Select all text. Cut it. Go into the Word. Paste. Control Home to go to the beginning. Then let's use replace command. I have it in Edit Replace menu. You probably somewhere in toolbar. Or press Ctrl H. Let's replace paragraph mark with two paragraph marks. Click More in Find What field. Click Special button, choose paragraph mark. In Replace With field, click Special button, choose paragraph mark twice. Click Replace All. Okay, we added empty lines between all paragraphs. Let's also add empty lines between sentences. Edit, replace. In Find Word field, type dot space. In Replace With field, put dot space, paragraph mark and paragraph mark. Click Replace All. The text that we have formatted like this seems to me will be more convenient to work with. Okay, continue. Ctrl A, select all. Right click, copy. Switch to WorkAudioBook. Right click, paste. Add empty space at the top. Turn edit off, save. Now when sentences are separated by empty lines, we do not see too much. Listen, try to understand, and only if you do not understand, go down in the text and look for your phrase.
To Sherlock Holmes, she is always the woman. I have seldom heard him mention her under any other name. In his eyes, she eclipses and predominates the whole of her sex. In his eyes, she eclipses and predominates the whole of her sex.
And so on. The WorkAudioBook program also has a version for Android. I should say that there, notes will be even more useful than in Windows. On Windows, you can always quickly switch to text in another program by pressing Alt-Tab. In Android, switching between programs is not so convenient, and of course, it is better when the text is visible right away in the player window. In this case, if you use the Android version of the program, I recommend to prepare files of notes in the Windows version and then copy them together with your MP3 files the way you usually copy files to your phone, for example via an USB cable. Now we have folder with MP3 files already opened. For the first file we edit our text. Let's go to the second file. Go, next file or F12. Open text for second file. Ctrl A, select all. Copy. If we need to improve it in text editor, switch to WorkAudioBook. Paste. Save. F12, next file. And so on. A few minutes and we will put all the text for MP3s into notes files. Sometimes an audiobook is split into hundreds of small MP3 files. Then, of course, it would take too much effort to arrange text among hundreds of files. In this case, put the text into the notes for folder. Or, if the text is very large, hundreds of pages, Android may not be able to cope with it. Then, divide these hundreds of MP3 files into subfolders, for example, by chapters of the book. And then, in these subfolders, copy the text into the notes for folders. Alright, let's say we edit text for all files. Go to Windows Explorer. And we see, here, next to our MP3 files, there are text files with notes. Select them all and copy to your phone. So, we have learned how to prepare text for audio. so that you can always be able to find and read a difficult phrase. In the next lesson, I will tell you about a list of words for study. Thank you for your attention.